Hello, in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your forms for your website to work with Super Submit using Expression Web. You can also use this video as reference if you're using FrontPage 2003 or SharePoint Designer 2007. The programs are analogous and pretty much everything that I'm going to do is the same in each of those editors. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is we're going to add a new form, and then we're going to go and click on the instructions button, and there we go. So this is the first step. So we're going to grab this form code, copy this, and then we're going to go to our website editor. Okay, so here we go. We're going to open up our contact page, and then we're going to, we'll do split view, I guess. We're going to go and find ourselves the form tag, the one that we want to be touching. Well, let's just move to design view. It might be a little bit easier here. So we find ourselves the input tag, and then we switch back to code view. This is just an easy way of identifying where the form tag is. So you're going to find in here probably a form tag that is already existing. You can paste yours just below this, so just as we've done here. But we want to retain any role or classes that would be from the previous form tag. So we're just going to copy that and paste it into our new form tag and then delete this, okay? So we need to make sure that we have an action that is to super submit slash our form identifier, the method equals post, and that the role is and class is whatever was previously there. Okay. Also, in many of our website templates, there may be a global form that was contained within a contact panel or a drop-down contact form. Depending upon your website template, it might be either one. In this particular one, I know that it is a, it's in components and then contact panel. And then in this particular one, it's contact panel HTM. Okay, so we're going to see another form tag here. We need to go back to our page and grab this same snippet of code, switch back to Expression Web, and paste it here. And just as we did before, we need to grab anything that looks like this, a class or a role, or if there's an ID, you want to retain that. But you want to make sure that the action and the method has been updated. Okay. You know, for that matter, we could have just simply grabbed this action and updated the action from the previous form tag if you want to. But, you know, we're just going to do it this way. And then always remember to make sure to remove the previous one. You can't have a form within a form. Okay. So that is now done. The next step, we're going to go back, is get spam protection. You really want to do this step. It's something that you could easily just skip over, but we really, really, really recommend that you go and get yourself a Google reCAPTCHA site key. It's completely free, protects your form from spam, and it's very easy to set up. So I'll just show you how to set it up. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to set it up for Super Submit, and that's just the name that we're giving it, supersubmit.co. All right, you don't need to enter in www. By doing this, it will use, you know, it works for www. If you wanted to. So we hit register. There we go. And then we get our keys. So this is the site key. So we just copy that. We go back to our interface and we paste it in here, and you're going to see that there's a little gear and a little check mark, and that'll save, and it's done. The next thing we need to grab is the site key. We just copy and just place our cursor in there and paste. Control V, or if you're on a Mac, I think it's probably Option V or something like that, or Command V. There you are. So they're different. You notice there's no trailing spaces here. If you go and hit anything else, you'll notice that the gear goes and then the check mark, it's an auto save. So it's now done. Okay. You don't have to hit save. And then the next part of this step is to copy this script element. Now, just select it and do Control C. Now, this next step is really important that you do right. If you have a site that uses a global form, such as I have right now with a contact panel, then you need to make sure that this snippet of code that I've just copied goes on all pages. Now, in our website templates, we include a template DWT, and this is just telling me changes made to the dynamic web template will not be applied to any attachment except if they are open for editing. Okay. Apparently I missed a step here in my site setup. I need to go to site settings and make sure that this is enabled. Yes. Hold on one second. Goodness gracious. So many checks and balances here. Okay. So now that we've gone and done that, I sure hope that my changes there for the form have saved. And they did. Very good. So what we want to do next here is go into the template DWT file. And this allows us, because if you take a look at any web page that is attached to a DWT file, has regions that are locked. You can't go in, well, you can go and monkey with it, but you really don't want to. By having a DWT, it allows you to go and paste something in. And then when you save, it propagates that change to all the pages within this structure where I've just placed it. Okay. If we were to put it within this editable region, which we don't want to do in the DWT, it will only put that snippet of code in new pages. Now we want it to be in all pages, so we place it outside of the editable regions, and then we hit save. Okay. Now I'm placing it just below, yes, I do want to update. I'm placing it just below the closing head tag. It really could be anywhere within the head. We're just gonna have it there. If you had a website that did not have a global form and had a DWT associated with it, just as we have here, you could place it within the editable region here, okay? But because we have the contact panel across the entire site, we need to make sure that that snippet of code is on all pages. Okay, and this is just the easiest way to do it, rather than going to each page and putting it in manually, putting it into the editable region here. It's the best way to do is just to put it into the DWT. Okay. Now, if you're not using one of our templates that uses this mechanism, then you're going to have to manually go in and place it into the head region. And when I say head region, I mean in each web page, you'll have an opening head tag, and then somewhere down here a closing head tag, and that's called the head region. Okay. So now that we're done that, we've obviously saved. We go to if we wanted to, that's the contact page. We've also, the last step is to set up the actual CAPTCHA element within the page. So to do that, we just grab this snippet of code and we go back to our editor and we find ourselves, we scroll down to where our form is, okay? And we're going to place this just above the submit button, okay? Don't forget that we also have, in this case, a contact panel, where we also need to place this within the form here, okay? So we're gonna place this right about here, okay? And hope that that displays just fine. We might wanna reduce this down a little bit. Maybe what we'll do is we'll place that in there, somewhere like that. Okay, and see if that works. Make sure you save, it's going to propagate out to all your pages. And then I'm going to publish out the contact page. Okay, now that's done. I'm going to go over to my contact. This is what it looked like beforehand. There was no CAPTCHA here. And up in the contact panel, there was no CAPTCHA. So we're going to reload this guy. Now we're going to see, maybe it hasn't finished saving yet. There we go. And you're gonna see that we have a CAPTCHA element right there. Okay. And then also in the contact panel, not quite formatted right now. You might need to go and add some extra padding or a clear fix around the around this element or move it into a different region. That's not really the scope of this particular video, how to modify CSS. Just basically to get the form operating. But it shows you that the CAPTCHA element is in there. So we're gonna hit send it. And what this is gonna do is it's gonna initialize the form. Fantastic, we've now done that. I'm gonna hit back now. And I'm going to demonstrate here that you can submit this form now, and the reCAPTCHA is going to go, whoa, hey, you haven't checked that checkbox. Go back and try it again. And now that I check the checkbox and hit submit, it will allow the form to submit. Now, because we haven't set up the page with any particular redirection settings for once the form has been submitted, it just resubmits to the same page. But you can go and, of course, explore those settings now. If we were to go back here and reload this page, you'll see that this is no longer pending. It is now active. And of course, advanced settings are found by clicking the settings button here. Anyways, I hope you find that helpful and it clears up any questions you might have. For any further instructions, you can go to your Manage Account and then down to, where is it, our Help Guide. And that will take you, and that's probably where you found this video in any case. That will answer all sorts of detailed questions about all sorts of advanced settings. Okay.